teenage boy who had just gotten his driver's license, and he went up to his dad to ask him to use the car. The dad said, "Son, I'll make a deal with you. If you'll get your grades up, if you'll read your Bible every day, and if you cut your hair, I'll let you borrow the car." A few weeks passed by, and the son came asking about it again. "Can I borrow the car?" The dad said, "Well, son, you've gotten your grades up. You've been diligent in reading your Bible, but you still haven't cut your hair." The son said, "Well, Dad, I've been thinking about it. Moses had long hair. Samson had long hair. Even Jesus had long hair." The dad said, "Yes, son. And they walk everywhere they went." I heard an amen to that. All right, I like it. Grace and peace to you from God the Father and from our Lord and Savior Jesus, who is the Christ. Amen. As we lead up to Christmas this year, we're going to look at one person in the Bible, just one person. And you may be surprised in who we've decided to select. We are going to be looking at Joseph, the earthly father of our Lord and our Savior. Now, you probably all think that you know Joseph, maybe because you've seen him in the nativity scenes, or maybe you've seen movies that have depicted him. But Joseph is a person in the Bible who never, ever says one word. Not a single word is described, spoken out of his mouth. In fact, if you look at only the Gospel of Mark, there is no mention at all of Joseph. Nothing. After the age of 13, when Jesus goes to the temple and his parents lose him, Joseph completely falls outside of history. We're not sure what happens. We don't know if he dies, and that's why he's not contained later in Jesus' ministry, or what happens. So there's a lot of confusion when it comes to Joseph. The church the last 2,000 years has really had to be creative as we've described who Joseph is. In fact, does anybody have a nativity scene at home? I want you to do something when you get home. I want you to take a look at your Joseph and your nativity scene. So I'm guessing there's either one of two varieties of Joseph. He's either depicted as a very elderly man with long gray hair, or a very young man. And this is done for a very specific reason. If you grew up in the Roman Catholic faith, you probably were used to seeing a very elderly Joseph. That's because for Roman Catholics, this idea that Mary and Joseph never consummated their marriage, that Mary was forever a virgin, is very important in their faith. And for them, Joseph would be better off being some elderly man who maybe lost his first wife, and this was some type of secondary marriage. And so if you're Joseph at home as an elderly Joseph, likely was made in a Roman Catholic factory by Roman Catholic artists. If, on the other hand, your Joseph is young, very young-looking man, next to a young-looking Mary, probably was made by a Protestant. Now, interestingly enough, our forefathers, both John Calvin and Martin Luther, both held this belief that this Joseph was elderly. Now, I stand before you saying, I don't know. Doesn't make a whole lot of difference to me. Scripture doesn't make it clear one way or the other, so when it comes down to it, it doesn't really matter. I hold the belief that he was young. I don't see why Mary and Joseph never had to consummate their marriage. It doesn't make any difference to me. I think this was kind of just an old-fashioned thing that people of faith never wanted to deal with. So my Joseph is more of a young Joseph. But now, no matter how you feel about Joseph, that's fine. Scripture doesn't make it. This series, though, I want us to look at what we do know. And there isn't a whole lot that we do know, but there are pieces, there are nuggets, fantastic things that we can mine to teach us about our faith. Does anybody remember, what did Joseph do? What was his occupation? He was a carpenter. That's right. In particular, he was a wood carpenter. In the New Testament, in the Greek, he's known as a tekton. T-E-K-T-O-N. A tekton. And if you go to the Holy Land, you may look around and you won't see very much for trees. up. And so Joseph wasn't building homes. In fact, most homes were built out of stone. What Joseph did as a tecton was build simple wooden pieces of furniture like this, or maybe a doorway, or maybe for a very fancy family, a dining room table. But Joseph, we typically think he built big, elaborate homes. He didn't do that. In fact, in our gospel message, you can kind of hear it, can't you? Is this the son of that carpenter Joseph? That tecton? That lowly, kind of second-class, blue-collar nothing Joseph? That tecton? This man who uses his hands and doesn't make a whole lot of money? Why would God bring his Savior through this man? For us living here, this day and age is beautiful, isn't it? I grew up on a farm, the son of a farmer, and I know many of you are blue-collar, working-class people. In the factories, wherever you might work, you are that Joseph. You are that tecton. And the beautiful part of this Christmas story is that God uses you. God uses those that the rest of the world doesn't really always value. That tecton, that carpenter, God, he wouldn't possibly do that. So what do we use with this? I want to speak in particular to the men in the congregation this morning. Men, we've had a bad run of it here the last couple of months. There's been a lot of males in our society that have pillaged who we are as males. I want us to look at Joseph as an example. How are you passing down your faith to the youth in this church, to the youth in the community, to those who are looking up to you? How are you passing down what it means to be a child of God to those who are looking at you? Because they are looking at you. This morning we look to Joseph, just like Jesus looked to his earthly father. I know Jesus learned a lot from Joseph. I believe he learned more from Joseph than any other human man in his life. We carry that mantle. It is our job to carry the faith, to walk in that light, to pass down that faith from our generation to those who come after us. Male, I need you. Men, I need you to rise up to be examples here in this community. Look to Joseph. Follow his example.